Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com, and if you're following along, this is the next segment in our total engine build for our 2017 Yamaha Raptor 700R. In this video, we're going to be focused on the shift shaft and the oil pump. So if you need those parts for your machine, why don't you check the link in the description below where that little arrow is, and it'll give you a shopping cart with all the parts that we use for this build. Now, if your machine's a little bit different, not a 2017, well, come to our website, Partzilla.com, and then drill down to your particular machine so you can get the correct parts. If you're still having trouble, then give us a call. That's what we're here for, and we can guide you to the correct parts for your application. So if you've got your parts together, let's take a look at the tools that we're going to need to pull this off. For once, there are no specialty tools. The only basic tools you're going to need are a 10mm socket, a 4 and a 5mm Allen, a pair of circlip pliers, a hammer, and a good torque wrench. So if you've got everything together, we can go ahead and get started. So let's go. And now let's start with the oil housing. So first up, let's go ahead and get our two O-rings for the intake and output of the oil pump itself. Next, go and lay in our gasket. Now the oil pump. So we're going to start with the top bolt. It's always been a rule of thumb of mine to use Loctite on, well, just about anything that's inside of the engine as far as the bolt goes. It just makes life easier. Don't tighten that top one all the way yet, because we still have to get the lower bracket and the bottom two bolts in place. Make sure you're lined up on that gasket. And once we get all three started in there by hand, then we'll come back and torque them. This little bracket is basically a windage tray for the gear that goes in here. So let's take those to 7.2, which of course I'm gonna take it to 8. I can actually stop it a little bit short, get closer to that 7.2 mark. Now we can go ahead and put in the gear. You'll notice that one side is a little bit more protruding out. That is the part that's going to go in first, and the part that's actually on the outside is concave. If you did it backwards, well, then this gear would machine itself against the bolts that are in there. We don't want that. So that's the side you want going in. And that gear is held in by a little circlip. Now we're going to put on the rest of the windage tray, a little bit more Loctite on the bolts that hold it down. Now these are a little bit smaller than the other bolts that were out here, so they're only at 2.9 foot-pounds, and that's not a lot, so be careful here. My torque wrench, actually as low as it'll go is 5, so we're just going to take a regular ratchet and just barely snug it down. And that should do it. All right, with that in place, let's start working on the shift mechanism. So let's start by getting what they call this shift drum segment in there. Once again, a little bit of Loctite. Just want to make sure that this detent lines up with that pin. If you were watching earlier, I have the reverse mechanism. The lever is in the up position, and it's actually holding my shift drum, because we have to get 22 foot-pounds on this bolt slash pin. And I didn't want to stress the transmission with the torque wrench doing that. But because that arm is actually reached in and it's holding the drum, it's going to pull against that arm versus stressing the transmission. There we go. All right, I already have this assembly put together, but just for clarity's sake, I'm going to pull it back apart, show you how it goes together, because chances are yours is not assembled and ready to go like this one is. So here's all our little pieces. Starts off, let's get the guide onto the holder and just roughly hold it in that position. And at this point, we'll start over on this side. We'll get a spring, get this piece in. Now, we want that curved edge to go in like that. And here's where it gets fun. Now we have to do the other side without all this flying apart. Same scenario, spring. Now trick is here to get it, bring it up into the guide. Wasn't that fun? And whatever you do, don't drop it, otherwise it's going to fly off in every single direction you can imagine. So now, let's carry it over and get it set in place. Like that. Once again, lock tight on these two outer bolts. And we're going to take those to 7.2. All right, with that in place, now we just need to get the shift shaft installed. So before we can install the shift shaft, there's a couple of pins that need to go in place into the case. This little small one, which actually is the holder for the spring, and this, which is a pivot point for the shift shaft itself. So let's get this little guy knocked in first. I'm just going to use a little 7mm socket to at least get it started, and then we'll tap it down. All right, we're going to drive it in a little bit further, but the trick is don't flush it all the way out, because we actually have to have the spring that's going to hook to it that extends down to that detent. That should do. So we're getting ready to install the shift stopper pin, and it actually goes into this part of the case. But if you look down, this particular hole goes straight into the engine, so you could drive it all the way in if you tried hard enough. So what we need to determine is, what is the correct depth? The manual really doesn't tell me. So what I did is go and put the shift shaft together. We're just going to drop it in place for a second. Then we're going to set it in place, and I basically want it to end up being even or a little bit protruding past that edge right there. So what I'm going to do, put a mark here. I'm going to flip it over, and that's the depth I'm going to drive it to, which looks like about 11, 12 millimeters, somewhere in there. Basically, it almost looks like I've cut it in half, so I'd say halfway the distance of the pin itself. That should do it. So before we put in the shift shaft, let's go ahead and put some assembly lube on it. Now let's drop it in place. There she is. Next, let's get the spring that goes in between that lower arm and that pin. Piece of cake. Okay, with that in place, we're going to go ahead and rotate it up, get the shift shaft seal in place. That's where our seal needs to go. A little bit of oil, and we'll get it pressed down. All I'm using here, guys, just a 13mm socket to get it pushed in. That'll do. I told you I was going to put on this arm and spring. I think I'm going to hold that till we get that case on, so that'll pretty much wrap this side up. We'll just put these aside until a little bit later in the build. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this particular segment up. If you need the parts list, check that link in the description. They're all right there. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Till next time, we just want to say thanks for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.